Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh and very good afternoon. Right, so I hope all of you are doing well and selamat menyambut puasa dan selamat beribadah dalam bulan Ramadan to all Muslim students. And I hope you are having enough energy to go through our lecture this afternoon. Before we begin this session, I just want to highlight that what we have gone through so far in week 2, we have gone through the aspect on entrepreneurship in innovation in terms of the goals and context, right? And last week, you have already looked into the business model canvas that I will relate later on that aspect to the activity that you are going to do in groups. So for this afternoon, just for a quick briefing on the topic on route to commercialization, from idea to market. Right, in terms of how I'm going to go through this afternoon lecture is basically to share my own experience. I have a few products that already successfully being commercialized, and probably this afternoon I'm going to share 3 of them. Right. And the first one is on a software called MyOBE. It's MyOBE is stand for Malaysian Outcome Based Education. So the product itself is being already being commercialized, and the name MyOBE has already been trademarked. Okay, let me go through the timeline of commercialization for this particular product. Alright, how to read this? So basically, the you can see here there are few stages of commercialization in terms of starting from the research and development, right? So we also have commercialization stages and what we call it as the business stage. So basically, right, so just a historical background to it. At the Faculty of Engineering, University Putra Malaysia, we started to implement or started to have an idea on outcome-based education way back in 2004. Okay, this is due to the fact that the Board of Engineers Malaysia have decided that Malaysia should go into the Washington Accord countries, Washington Accord signatory countries, where it requires any engineering program that are being offered in institution of higher learning in Malaysia should implement their engineering teaching and learning via outcome-based education technique. So at the Faculty of Engineering, we decided that yes, we need to ensure the engineering program at the Faculty of Engineering fulfill the requirement by the Board of Engineers Malaysia. So that's we started our outcome-based education workshop in 2004, and we already started to have a program design and implementation. So when we have the ideation in terms of what need to be done for the framework of outcome-based education, we find out that there is a need to have a suitable system, the automation system that going to do the management as well as the implementation of the outcome-based education. So in 2007, we feel that yes, we need this particular system, online system, automation system, and we request seed funding from the Ministry of Higher Education. And alhamdulillah, we managed to get some seed money, around 200,000 ringgit, and to start our journey to developing the system. So we engage one programmer, and we group in a few personnel among the academic staff at the Faculty of Engineering, and we come up with the prototype of MyOBE. And basically, that is already going into the development stages. Of course, the research stages, the literature review, the needs, and the requesting funding that bridge us from research to development, And from the seed money that we obtain from Ministry of Higher Education, we provide or we produce a prototype. At the same time, we try to protect our ideas by applying for patent through Malaysian Patent Office. Okay, this is patent pending number. At the same time, we also provide a copyright, the programming, the routine, the equations that we put in the system, we do the copyright, and at the same time we file for patent. So basically the system itself, the framework itself, we patent it, right? So and then we at the same time when we patent to Malaysia, and we also apply patent to the what we call it is as international patent, India Patent Office, Australian Patent Office, Japan Patent Office, and at the same time we also what we call it as participating in various innovation and design competition. Like in UPM, we managed to go into MTE in 2011, Malaysian Technology Expo, Percipta 2011. And of course, when you see this particular logo, right, this our first customer that bought our system. So the system being used in University Putra Malaysia, especially at the Faculty of Engineering. And by 2011, we managed to convince University Selangor to try out our system. Try out meaning that they bought our system. So we at a very, very, very low cost. And we install it at Unicell and they use it at that particular time. And this transition from development goes into commercialization, that where ideas started from research, we nurture it, we develop it, and we get some seed funding. And finally, we find out, yes, it's about time to sell it to others, to our friends in other universities. So Unicell is our first customer, and it goes to other various institutions, the Polytechnic, Jabatan Pengurusan Polytechnic, right? The whole Polytechnic is using our system. And then University Technology Mara, UITM Shah Alam, Faculty of Mechanical Engineering, and we also have University Pertahanan Malaysia, Faculty of Engineering, and we also enter again Percipta 2013 in the commercialization category. And at the same time, I think this is a logo of University of Nizwa. This is King Saud University, King Saud University in Saudi Arabia. So we send our representative to King Saud University in Saudi Arabia to install the system over there and conduct training. So as you can see here, from 2004 to 2008, we consider that as a research stage, 4 years of research and around 3 years of development. And from development 2011 until 2014 is the commercialization stage. And it's not yet business per se, because we are just using the platform of UPM Holding to market our product. And beginning 2015, that is where we go into the next step of business, where we have what we call it as the spin-off, where later on in our lecture, I'm going to provide you in terms of the pathway of commercialization, where we in this particular case, the IP that we produce earlier being licensed to a company. This company is basically a company that provided it is a spin-off from the project. So we have our own programmer becoming the first CEO of the company, right? It is called Mick Edusis. And at that particular time, 2016 or 15, we got our Japan patent granted. Of course, if you can see earlier, we have Malaysian patent, Japan patent, India patent, Australian patent. But we got the patent granted in 2015 for Japan. and we got 2016-17 for our Malaysian patent granted. So you can see that the time of patent being granted is it takes some time for Malaysia. It's around 7 years, whereas in Japan it's only 5 years. We withdraw from India, we withdraw from Australia, because it's costly to maintain the patent filing. And through this company, we managed to sell the product to GMI, and they also improve in terms of the using cloud system, and now it's already a history. So this is one example of how the idea from we bring to the market, that go through the research, development, commercialization, and the business aspect. And as you can see here, we took one of the pathway of commercialization that is involving spin-off company. All right. Let us go through another product that I'm personally also involved in, which is called vacuum blood container, right? So in this particular case, basically, the students from the Master of Innovation and Engineering Design themselves get involved. There are roughly about 5 students getting involved in this particular project. Let me get you through the commercialization pathway. But before that, just to highlight what is a vacuum blood container. Basically, a vacuum blood container is normally being used by doctors in hospitals or nurses whenever you want to get your blood test, right? So the medical officers will get some or withdraw some blood from your body and put it inside this container to be sent to the labs. So in our case, the existing product, the vacuum blood tubes that being produced initially, they use what we call it as the penetration. In order for them to vacuum the tube, they have to use syringes, right, with needles in order to extract the air from the tube. However, in our innovation, in our invention, basically, we do not need to use this. What we call it as the penetration technique. What we design the cap itself having louvers that allows the air to withdraw from the tube without any penetration, and we close the cap to get a vacuum product. So in terms of the development, it is also a long history, meaning that it is not just 1 or 2 years of development. It started way back in 2007, where we come across this problem from a company, company called Celiatech, the company here. But when we discussed with them, they said that they would like to engage us, the program, Master of Innovation program, to provide solution to their problem. So basically, they would like to come up with a product, a new design. So we collaborate with them, and they provide some seed money, and we manage to do product design, laboratory prototype, and proof of concept. So basically, the product itself, the project for the research and development are being funded by the company, right? A collaboration. So they provide us a place for our student to go and to provide engineering activities over there. And together with Celiatech, we filed for patent in 2010, and we go into several competition, and we also decided that yes, we need to file for US patent and Australian patent, right? And in 2012, we managed to get the engineering prototype from the laboratory prototype and proof of concept. It took us nearly 3 years to produce an engineering prototype. When we say engineering prototype, meaning that the product itself has already go through soft molding at the company, and we produce hard molding, meaning that it is for mass production. And US patent granted in 2015, right? And Malaysian patent granted in 2018. Of course, Malaysia take longer time, as I said in the earlier example. And by 2017, the Universiti Putra Malaysia decided that we would like to sell the IP to the company because it's no longer of the interest of the university to service the IP, meaning that we do not have to spend more money. We then sell the IP to the company in 2017. And through funding by venture capitalists, I helped the company to secure 5 million ringgit fund, to get the operation of the manufacturing, to mass produce the product. So we from the 5 million ringgit funding, we purchase the what we call it as the machinery, the automation for the product from Korea as well as from Japan. And I believe in last year, the product itself has gone through the process of for clinical trial and already being accepted by the Ministry of Health for usage in the government hospital, and that is already a history. And this is one of the success story that I personally involved in this particular project. And at the same time, we also collaborate with the same company, Celiatech, to develop another product, what we call it as a safety syringe. So this project also involved students from Master of Innovation, and there are three students involved in it. And basically, how it works, basically the normal syringes, because the company itself they produce syringes of 3 mil, 5 mil, and 10 mil for local usage for government hospital through Farmaniaga, and they would like to produce a safety syringes. So basically, how it works, the needle holder itself being disengaged from the barrel. So when we push the plunger, this is a plunger, and when we finish using it, we just press it further up, and then the needle holder will disengage. So that's how it works, and the pattern that we produce in this particular project. So similarly with the vacuum tube, the safety syringe also gone through a similar process. It is not just 1 or 2 year process from R&D to business. It takes from ideation 2009 to product design, laboratory prototype, and then we have patent pending. There are reason why we patent so many in the early stage, because we feel that safety syringe, it is much more usage in African countries. We have Ghana, so we try out Indonesia at the same time, right? We have UAE there, India, US, Australia, and Japan. Okay, and of course we won a few awards through this particular product in Bio Innovation Award, the Pencipta, and we got special funding from the Ministry of Higher Education. Okay, we got the prototype research grant scheme, to produce the prototype, and we managed to produce the engineering prototype with the same company, Celiatech. And at the same time, 2017, we transfer the technology, we sell the IP to the Celiatech company, that we also managed to get US patent as well as Malaysia patent in 2019. So at the moment, Celiatech has not yet produced in mass yet for the safety syringe, because they are focusing on the vacuum blood container. So as you can see from the three example that I've personally gone through with the lecturers in UPM, at the same time through partnership with the company. Okay, as there are two, if you listen carefully just now, there are two pathways that we gone through. And the first one is spin-off, meaning that we from the IP itself, we do not sell the IP to the company, we license the IP to the certain company. And at the same time, the second and the third product, right, that we take the pathway on selling off the technology, selling off the IP. So the IP now belongs to the company, Celatech company, and basically the researcher doesn't get, or the university doesn't get any royalty anymore, because we already got the money that we, when we sell the IP. So I would like to stop my lecture now.